Drake University Legal Clinic, producing outstanding lawyers with a balance of theory and practice.
But I came in 71. We started over on 2801 Brattleboro, just a couple blocks from here, in a run-down house, and I mean really run down, that we developed a national program that all the law schools could compete for grant money. And that is actually, that program, the Title IX program, the Higher Education Act, is the very thing that spread clinical legal education throughout the country. And today, many of the people teaching in legal education, especially in legal clinics, it was because of that program. So in effect, what started here at Drake University was really responsible for spreading it throughout the country.
Well, I'm Neil Smith, and I was raised in southeast Iowa. But anyway, I came here to Drake, and I liked Drake Law School, and my wife came with me. She was one of only three in the class that graduated in 3 women that graduated in 1950. And so in the 1970s, the Legal Aid Corporation was set up. And it was great. The lawyers and the judges were all for it because, after all, if you're a criminal, you have a right to a legal service. But if you're a law-abiding citizen, don't have the money to pay for access to the courts, you can't get there. It was a part of the deal was trying to get more services for the poor.
But the truth of the matter is, it's very critical for the law students to have that hands-on experience. I like to use the athletic analogy. You talk it, you chalk it, and you walk it. You have the lecture, you have the diagram or the samples, and then you actually go through it. You do it yourself.
We were pathbreaking in terms of the legal clinic, in terms of starting it back in the early 1970s, and have always been a leader in that and been nationally recognized for that. The trial practicum also recognized an opportunity that this type of experiential education could be brought into the first year. And so the concept that we have was a three-sided or three-legged pyramid, that in the first year you could have an observation experience where you were exposed to the practice of law, to the justice system, to see what judges actually do and to see the jury work. In the second year, you could begin a simulation type of experience. And we offer courses in trial advocacy, negotiations, mediation, and other courses, even like evidentiary suppression motions, deals with the argument of a motion to suppress in a criminal case in a simulated setting. And we do that both in our courtroom right here. The courtroom in the Smith Law Center is a great setting to be able to have that kind of simulation experience. And then after half of your law school career, you can then qualify under the Iowa Supreme Court student practice rule. And that allows what I call a participation experience. So observation in the first year, simulation in the second and third years, and then the opportunity for a participation experience in the third year. That's a hallmark of our experiential education here at Drake.
Law students who have successfully completed the equivalent of 3 semesters of law school may apply for an Iowa student practice license. Once admitted under the state student practice rule, participants in clinic programs are permitted under faculty supervision to appear as counsel on civil and misdemeanor criminal matters and to represent clients in matters before the Iowa Court of Appeals or the Supreme Court of Iowa.
What the legal clinic is all about is having a supervision by a faculty member, a licensed attorney with lots of experience. They receive a student license from the Supreme Court. They do everything that a lawyer would do in representing that client, meeting with the client, drafting letters, documents, pleadings, questioning witnesses, going to court, all under the supervision of a licensed attorney, a faculty member, so that they really can't get hurt, or the clients can't get hurt, but they have hands-on experience of actually being a lawyer while they're in law school yet.
The Neil and B. Smith Law Center, a 40,000-square-foot, fully computerized facility, houses the law school's clinical programs and the Center for Public Service Attorneys. Noted for its stunning architecture, the building includes classrooms, conference rooms, offices, a library, courtroom, and atrium.
They get a lot of court appearances. We do a fair amount of family law because I try to have the students get interviewing, counseling, negotiation, legal drafting, mediation, motion practice. and possible trial, and the family law cases get them all of those skills while in one area of law that they really have to master. So there's a bit of a focus there and on domestic abuse representation, specifically within family law and adoptions. Then we do some small claims cases and other things to get them an idea of other areas of the law. One of the really fun things in teaching clinic is the seeing the student confidence grow. At the beginning of the semester, they're extremely nervous. They're almost scared to death to see a judge, to talk to a judge. They're shocked that the clients view them as lawyers. And by about a month in, they're already comfortable bringing motions to the judge and orders to sign, and not necessarily a full trial. They're, of course, still very scared about that. There's also, of course, the case management system and computerized work in terms of keeping their hours and keeping notes of their cases, which is important for practice and also very important for a place where the most of the attorneys change every 3 months. Clinic makes students probably about the equivalent of a second year associate, because by having this experience, they learn how to deal with clients, how to deal with opposing counsel, how to deal with judges, how to deal in a law office, all of that kind of thing.
One of my first loves is clinical legal education. Live client clinical education is still a little rare when you look at law schools across the country. So one of the unique aspects of the Drake Legal Clinic is that we have such a diverse clinical program. And we're looking at expanding into even more diverse types of clinical education programs.
Elder law is becoming a huge necessity in Iowa, across the nation, but here in Iowa especially, as we have an aging population with the baby boomers. And so working with the elderly is becoming something that the students are desiring from any level.
The criminal defense program consists of three clinics. One is the intro clinic, the second is the advanced trial clinic, and the third is the advanced appellate clinic. In your intro clinic, you'll be handling any number of cases, probably between 15 and 20 cases per semester. Each one of those cases usually is an indictable misdemeanor. And what that means is the individual can be sentenced up to 2 years in prison. You are responsible for handling the case from its inception to its conclusion. You're supervised by me, and we will go through the various proceedings that will take place in any criminal trial, whether it's here in Iowa or any other state in the United States. The idea behind experiential education at Drake is to let students go through this experience and understand that they can build the confidence in order to identify those issues, to identify problems, and come up with solutions, legal solutions to those problems that the clients have.
I've been involved in mediation for over 20 years. I fell into it seeing some friends that were involved in mediation that saw that it was a much better way of parties resolving disputes than having the costly endeavors and often the emotional endeavors of going to court. So I became intrigued by it and began my own mediation firm, which went into 5 states. Mediation began a number of years ago. We're probably most familiar with it in the labor union type disputes. It then began to spring up as an opportunity to resolve civil cases. And that probably happened about 25 years ago. Eventually, it's now evolved to the courts being so enthused about it that in many jurisdictions, you have to go to mediation before you can get a trial date. And the statistics are staggering at the number of cases that will settle when you go to mediation. And the feedback that, again, we're getting from parties is that they're much more satisfied by the results that are achieved in mediation because they're results that they come up with rather than having imposed on them by a third party. I usually work with about 5 or 6 students in the mediation clinic, and those are students that get excited about being a problem solver. Those are students that in the mediation course learn that maybe this is why I went to law school. I don't necessarily want to be a gladiator. I want to be a problem solver. I want to help parties get resolution of their matters in a way that's beneficial to them.
We do limit how many people can come into the clinic. We try to do about 8 per clinic, and that's because we want to make sure each student gets a lot of different cases. Otherwise, you have X number of cases, and if you had 25 students, they wouldn't have much time with the faculty member, they wouldn't have very many cases, and they wouldn't really get the opportunity to learn that they could really have if it were a smaller clinic class. So they're very small clinic classes. In the juvenile law clinic, for instance, that I supervise, I'd estimate, it's the only clinic that's a 2-semester clinic, and I would estimate that every one of our students in that clinic goes to court at least 40 times in that year. So they've got a lot of experience by the time they leave law school, by the time they graduate.
Engineered for the electronic presentation of trials, the courtroom has videotaping and playback capabilities, as well as broadcast options for multiple screens.
The building housing the Drake Legal Clinic is really one of the nicest legal clinic facilities in the country. We've been designated as a courtroom for the 5th Judicial District in Iowa, an official site for court to be held. And that means that we're able to have Supreme Court arguments in our courtroom. We've had 8th Circuit arguments in the courtroom. But more importantly, each year we actually have a real jury trial that's held in our courtroom with the real judge, real lawyers, real jurors, real parties. If it's a criminal case, real defendants. If it's a civil case, real parties, and real witnesses. Our students then, first-year students, have 1 week where they are not in class, but they come over, it's what we call the trial practicum, to the legal clinic and actually watch that real trial. And they see it in person, they have an opportunity to visit with other lawyers and judges while it's going on to see what is happening, what's the strategy, what's the law that's involved, what motions are being made, all of those types of things. So they actually get to see what's really happening. When it's all over with, they have an opportunity to visit with the judge, ask questions of the judge that heard that trial, the lawyers who were part of that trial, and even the jurors who were part of that trial. They have a chance to visit with those judges, lawyers, and jurors and find out why things happened the way they did and what impressed jurors and what didn't and so forth. It's a unique opportunity, and by unique, I mean there's not a law school in the country that does this.
Clients enter law offices with life issues that complicate their legal issues. The Drake Legal Clinic employs a licensed master social worker to assist both students and clients in assessing these other needs and identifying outside services to meet those needs.
We take a holistic approach here at the clinic, and you know, these legal issues aren't occurring in a vacuum. I mean, that's not the only thing that people come to us with, and a lot of them have emotional and social needs that are that need to be met as well, and so we provide that service for them.
Students learn to identify underlying issues their clients may be experiencing and how to effectively collaborate with other professionals to identify community resources. Clients are represented in a way that will ensure all of their needs are addressed. By addressing the life issues as well as the legal issues, our student attorneys learn the real meaning of zealously advocating for their clients.
I'm just very optimistic about the future of the clinic. There's no question in my mind that in the next few years we will have more areas of clinics in this legal clinic at Drake. I would anticipate somewhere down the line we'll have an immigration law clinic. I think we'll have a general practice clinic. We have all kinds of areas, probably an appellate law clinic where students will actually write briefs and argue appeals in real cases before the Iowa Supreme Court and the Iowa Court of Appeals. I think that we do have tremendous opportunity for growth here because so many students want to be involved in clinic and because Drake is so committed to give those students clinical opportunities when they want one.
I can't imagine going through law school and graduating and just going straight into practice without having this type of experience.
The students already have had some exposure in actually litigating real cases in a real courtroom, and so they're better able to represent clients competently and confidently when they get out into the private practice.
how to work with clients, how to build that relationship and that rapport.
If you want to be a trial attorney or a practicing attorney, you can't do any better than go to Drake.
When you get out into practice, you can jump right into practice and not be a clerk for another year out of law school.
Interviewing, negotiating, dealing with difficult people under difficult circumstances, which is what we do as lawyers. We're problem solvers. And I think a lot of people forget that that's our real role here. It's not about our ego, it's about our clients and our ability to solve those problems for our clients.
It just gave me a much greater sense of compassion.
The results of the students' experiences in the clinic in dealing with live clients, there's a tremendous growth in self-esteem where they come to the attitude, hey, I can do it.